Thank you. Good morning, friends. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. And those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live." And again, in the book of Revelation, we hear these words, "I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys to hell and death. Because I live, you shall also live." Friends, we've come together today to praise God and to give thanks to our faith as we bear witness to this resurrection hope, and giving thanks especially for the life of Hal, a person who has brought so much life, so much light and joy to many of you. And in the short time that I've been here, I've heard many Hal stories of the things that he has contributed to each other individually, and the things that his presence has contributed to this very church. And so it's customary, when a person like Hal dies, for us to come together in grief, because his passing leaves a hole in our lives and in this community. But the scriptural promises that I have just read, they help us. They help us to not grieve as those without hope. But it's in the midst of grief today that we are able to celebrate. To celebrate how? And to celebrate this resurrection faith, which reminds us that today is a joyous day. Because Hal is home. He's with God. He's with his family. And so for that we give thanks. And I'll invite you to stand as you are able, in body or spirit, as we sing together hymn number 369 in the United Methodist Hymnal, "Blessed Assurance."
Thank you.
Please pray with me. Most holy and ever-loving God, the one in whom we live and move and have our being, as we come to you today, we acknowledge that you know our needs before we ask, and our ignorance in asking. And so give us now your grace, that as we stand before the mystery of death, we may see the light of eternity. Give us fresh ears to hear your message of life and of death, and help us to live as those who are prepared to die, so that when our days here are accomplished, we may go forth to live, knowing that living or dying, our life is held in your hand. We pray all of these things through Christ our Lord. Amen. Friends, will you please read with me the 23rd Psalm found printed in your bulletin? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. At this time, I'll invite Ruth Gaddy to come to read scripture and to say some words of remembrance.
This is from Ecclesiastes 3, verse 8. For everything there is a season, a time for everything. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant, a time to pluck up its planting. A time to cure, a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love, a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. I think Hal would be pleased that I would have read this passage. He and I were good friends for many years. And he would want me to say this. Hal was a testament to all the wonderful cooks that have gone to this church throughout the years. Because when he could not come to a meal, people would fix a box that I would take to him. So he was always here, and he always enjoyed the food. And we did a lot of different things together, and I was able to, once he was placed in assisted living, I was able to take programs by to him on Sundays. He made a lot of friends there. In fact, he had a picture of one of the residents, a lady named Dee, in his room. Adjusted very well. And we all know that medically everything was done, and this was his time to die. Thank you.
Thank you. do I feel discouraged? Why do the shadows come? And why does my heart Jesus is my portion, a constant prayer is He, His eyes on the and I know He watches me. His eyes are the sparrow, and I know He watches. And I see because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know He watches me. So I sing because I'm happy, and I sing because I'm free. Yes, His eye is on the sparrow. And I know He watches.
My name is Dustin Mailman. I'm one of the pastors here at Trinity United Methodist. I'm grateful we get to be here today and to remember and grieve and make sense of the life of Hal Alexander. Our scripture this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 19, verses 1 through 10. He entered Jericho and was passing through it. A man was there named Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector and was rich. He was trying to see who Jesus was, but on account of the crowd, he could not, because he was short in stature. So he ran ahead and climbed a sycamore tree to see him, because he was going to pass that way. When Jesus came to the place, he looked up and said to him, "Zacchaeus, hurry and come down, for I must stay at your house today." So he hurried down and was happy to welcome him. All who saw it began to grumble and said, "He has gone to the guest of one who is a sinner." Zacchaeus stood there and said to the Lord, "Look, half of my possessions, Lord, I will give to the poor. And if I have defrauded anyone of anything, I will pay back four times as much." Then Jesus said to him, "Today salvation has come to this house, because he too is a son of Abraham. the Son of Man came to seek out and to save the lost. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Often when we think about mountaintop experiences, we don't think of tragedy, but they always end with a descent into the valley. In this moment that we're finding in the scripture, we find a divine encounter followed by a seeping more deeply into the reality of this world. That there is an incarnational task of figuring out what's it mean to stand atop a mountain and what's it mean to be down in the valley and see God. This is the task, seeking God. This particular passage has Jesus traversing through a lush, desertous area that's known for tax collectors to hang around. There's prolific palm forests left and right. And the first century audience would know Jericho as the place of divinity. It would be called the fattest land. In an intersection where worlds collide, as we come together today, we consider how this site where worlds collide, where we saw joyfulness and we saw curiosity, where we saw persistence and where we saw struggle. Jesus was passing through Jericho again to sit in this location. Jesus knew Zacchaeus' name because Zacchaeus was the one who ascended the tree and wanted to see Jesus. He heard of this gospel and wanted to know more. The infectiousness of Jesus' ministry nudged Zacchaeus to sift through the crowd and to climb the tree for the sake of the good news. Today we are indeed wrestling and grieving and honoring the reality that Hal Alexander has died in body. Despite this reality, Hal continues to remind us of the infectiousness of the gospel. Again, as I was praying over who Hal was in my own life, persistence is the word that kept coming to me. I saw some grins. Y'all know how it was persistent. I heard stories often on how he was persistent in his sitting in the shotgun seat of the van in order to come and pick up those who were homebound with Paul Manning. I heard about his persistence as he somehow wrangled a job at the barbershop to sweep up hair. How he would do everything he could to sneak a plate home from the potluck or get a ride from church so he didn't have to do his recommended exercise. When I think about how, I also remember how every single Sunday he would hold up his hand like this. Everyone else got a handshake, but he wanted to dap me up. We were buds. I told Jeremy before I walked up the steps today that Hal was the first person to congratulate me in the church on being commissioned, which was immediately followed by, "Oh, I like those robes and that cross. Can I have them?" This is the exact cross. He never got his hands on it, but I know he would receive it if he could. And then finally, what I want to say that some of y'all may know, some of y'all may not, but every single sermon that's preached at this church, Hal would seek out whoever the preacher was, say, "Could I have your manuscript?" And once the preacher would scurry up to get the manuscript, he would say, "Sign it." He made me feel like a football star. I bet he has an incredible collection of sermons from Trinity through his entire time here. Because Hal was persistent, this is how we know that what he longed for was connection. He was a large man in stature, but his sense of humility and humor, connection to his family, anytime he would mention his mother, he would tear up. His connection to those Carolina Tar Heels, and his connection to this church.
If there's anything that Hal modeled with his life more than anything, was how the infectiousness of the gospel could create houses of connection and belonging, and how, despite how frustrated folks might have been, or the joy that Hal settled it within folks, that this was a place where he felt connected. Most everyone who is here connected with Hal because of this infectiousness of the gospel. Regardless of all that he had to carry, and all those who were around him had to carry through the entirety of his life, he is a living testament that where community is at, God is there. Hal, like Zacchaeus, wanted to ascend that tree and seek connection with the living God through his community. Reminds us that when we start from a place of humility and persistence and a longing for connection and humor and friendliness, persistence, our legacy is one of the kingdom. If we believe that the God who is able to humble themselves to the point of death and is alive today, we should be able to believe that Hal was created in God's image, persistent in longing for connection, and settled in his community. In addition to Hal's connection, he suffered. He struggled to exist in a world that didn't know what to do with his big body and his difference in ability. He found connection with God, and he rested in Jesus' arms, and he is free from the way that the world was not accessible to him. When I describe the mountaintop experience as a tragedy, it's because there is no tragedy in the treetop experience. The mountaintop experience is about us feeling, but the treetop experience is about us seeking. How sought connection, that bracelet, that necklace, that coloring page, that boxed meal that Ruth mentioned. How never stop seeking, and this is my invitation for us. How might we say yes to the invitation that Hal offered to us in this lifetime, as he walks with us into eternity today? How might we say yes to the invitation to not look for God in the up high places, but in the second pew in the front corner with a red pew God held over his head? Regardless of, again, the back and forth of the role Hal played in our life, how can we say yes to his invitation to live fully into our identities as children of God? May Hal's life be a testament to the treetop faith of Zacchaeus. And may we create the space that we need to fully honor Hal's life on this day and the days to come. I'll say it again, and y'all need to giggle if you need to, but Hal was persistent. Hal struggled. And Hal was and is and forever shall be a child of God, resting in the glory of God. May we all come to know that that is true for each of us too. Amen.
Friends, will you please stand as you are able as we affirm our faith together? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. You may be seated. Will you please pray with me? Most holy God, we come to you today thankful for all with which you have blessed us with, even today. For the gift of joy and days of health and strength. And for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise. In days of pain and grief. We praise you for home, for family, community, and friends. But most of all, we praise you for our baptism and place within your church, with all who have faithfully lived and died. And we praise you especially for how Alexander. Holy God, all that you have given us is yours. And as you have offered Hal to us, we give him back to you, asking that you receive him into the arms of your mercy, and that you raise him up with all of your people. Receive us also and raise us into newness of life. So that inspired by Hal and his witness, we might love and serve you better in this world, that we may enter into your joy in the world to come. And so it is with humble hearts that we offer you these prayers today, using the prayer that Christ himself taught to us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Friends, I'll invite you to stand as you are able in body or spirit as we sing together hymn number 504 in the United Methodist Hymnal, The Old Rugged Cross.
Thank you.
Friends, this concludes our service today. But I want to remind everyone, for those who are able to attend, House Graveside, service will be at 2:15 at Forest Lawn Memorial Park in Camden. And if you haven't seen the slideshow of his life, you may do so directly after the service here. Please receive this benediction. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of the Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And may the blessings of Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.